SLI stands for Specific Language Impairment, and it's a kind of language learning impairment which is very isolated in that the child doesn't have a lot of other developmental difficulties, but language seems to be the particular problem. It's a bit of a mystery as to why it should be so, because you have a child who's otherwise developing very normally. They learn to walk at the normal age, they can look after themselves and so on and so forth. But for some reason, language poses a particular problem for these children, and so both talking and understanding of language may be affected.
I found everything difficult. It was really extremely hard for me because I couldn't spell, couldn't really talk properly, didn't understand what other people were saying to me, and I didn't really understand anything, and it was just kind of really hard.
The surprising thing for many people is just how common SLI is. It's thought that there's at least one child in every classroom who'll have a specific language impairment. It's at least as common as dyslexia, and it's certainly very much more common than autism, both of which are much better known as developmental conditions. The problem with SLI is it's such a hidden disability that it often goes unrecognised unless a child is given a specific assessment.
Sometimes in English, there's a lot of noise going around me, and I'm trying to listen to concentrate with one word, and my other ears are trying to listen with the conversation, so it's kind of hard.
Didn't know any words really. I was in English with this teacher, and she kept on asking me these questions, and I had no clue. I was just blank. Didn't know anything really.
It's important that SLI is diagnosed because we need to make accommodations for these children. We need to realise that they're not just being idle or stupid if they don't always respond to what people say. There is a professional speech and language therapist that can offer appropriate help for these children, but obviously if they're not diagnosed, they're not going to get access to those sorts of services.
My point of view is I don't think anyone knows they've got a problem with speech and language or anything like that, because I didn't know, my family didn't know, and it took us a very long time for me to know. So I hope that this would go out and whoever watches this would make them think like, ah, my kid's got that, or I have that. So, cross fingers.